Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, what's up? Who are we speaking with?
Hey, what's up, man? This is TruthSeekah?
Yeah, it's Maddie.
Yeah, what's up, man? How's it going, bro? It's a pleasure to be on the show.
Yeah, no doubt. Jordan can't hear you, but if you let me know the question, I'll ask him right quick, and you can listen online.
Yeah, no worries. So, basically, my question, aside from religion, was I think one of the biggest tools that the elite, the Illuminati of this world have against us is using fear as a paradigm of controlling us and believing that we are too stupid to get beyond this problem. And one of the biggest tools we can use against them is love. Love destroys fear, it destroys hate, and they have taken that away from us.
Okay, so what do you want to ask?
I basically want to ask him what he thinks about Donald Trump's divide and conquer between the people. I personally think that one of Donald Trump's biggest things he's done to the people is divide and conquer them further and use fear to get us all controlled.
Okay. All right, Maddie, I will ask him that, and you can listen on hold. All right, so it's pretty much a two-part question. First of all, Donald Trump, divide and conquer. What's going on with Donald Trump?
First of all, I don't care about the mundane world I live in. So I don't care who Caesar is today and who the great leaders of the world are today. I don't care about that. I'm smart enough to know that we live in a system. And the scripture very clearly says over and over that Satan is the god of this world. Period. End of sentence. Nothing to discuss. Therefore, whatever happens on a national or international scale in politics is simply a system by which men have put together institutions that we call the police department, the sheriff, insurance companies and banks, educational colleges and universities, government and laws and money, and all of these are man-made systems. And if you don't understand all of them and understand how they interconnect, then you're going to be worried sick over who's the president and what's he going to do and what's going to happen to us at the end of the world, and is Russia going to attack us? And the scripture says you're going to hear all of these words and all these things about wars here and wars there, and you're going to hear about the preachers and all the clergy and all the holy rollers and all the imbecilic morons who are going to church and preaching all these ridiculous, stupid stories. Why? That keeps you agitated. That keeps you concerned and worried. And the reason we know that it works is because today, if we confront you with actual facts of life, you have no idea what we're talking about. Why? Because you're so concerned about the president or the vice president or what the senator did or what China's going to do. I'm more concerned what God's going to do. I don't care about the American system. I don't care about the Chinese system. I care about truth.
Yeah.
And who we really are, all of us, including China, the Russians, the Africans, and we ourselves in America. All mankind, the scripture says, lies in the power of the wicked one. So the reason why you're concerned about government and concerned about the president and who they really are and what they're really doing is because that's who you are. You're a child of this world. I'm not a child of this world. I did not come here to be a child of the world I live in.
Yeah.
I came because I have something to do. I'm a teacher.
I think that's Jesus 101. My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight. And his kingdom is not of this world. Donald Trump would not be the president of Jesus, or Caesar, you know what I'm saying? He didn't bow to Caesar, so his kingdom was not of this world. And if you are a child of light, you would not concern yourself in the affairs of poly tricks and get caught up.
I didn't say that. Scripture says that.
Exactly. Exactly. 101. Jordan's just repeating what Jesus said, y'all. I mean, come on. He's just saying the same thing Jesus said. It's awesome, man. I love it. All right, so we got another caller who I guess he couldn't hear a while ago. So we'll go back to Arkansas. I believe this is Hunter. You got a question, Hunter? If you enjoyed listening to this podcast segment, be sure to listen to the entire episode by clicking the video to your right. Also, we are on iTunes. You can download the MP3 versions as well. Be sure to subscribe for future episodes.